श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू अवर ऑनलाइन टीचिंग एकेडमी एकलैवा। सीबीएसई क्लास 1 सब्जेक्ट ईवीएस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू लेसन। द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज अमेजिंग वर्ल्ड ऑफ एनिमल्स। वी हैव सीन मेनी एनिमल्स। Some animals will be very small and some will be very big. So, some animals, they live on land. They are called as land animals. See, these animals, they live on land. They are called as land animals. Some animals, they live on water. They are called as aquatic animals. Some animals, they live both on land and in water. So they live, sometimes they will be in the water and sometimes they will be in the land. So they are called as amphibians. They are called as amphibians. Where do we live? We live in a home, that is house. So, like that, animals also are staying in their own houses. They are called as, their home is called as habitat. Their home is called as habitat. So, where does a dog live? Dog lives in a kennel. Rabbit, burrow, lion, den, sparrow. That means the birds. The birds are also live in their nest. These are the some examples for the animals where they live. Their home of animals are called as habitat. So animals can be divided into many groups. They are animals, wild animals, domestic animals, pets, birds, insects. So animals are divided into wild animals, domestic animals, pets, birds, and insects. Now we are going to see one by one. First we are going to see wild animals. Animals that live in jungle or zoo. Whether you all have gone to zoo? Yes, very good. What are the animals you will see in the zoo? Lion, tiger, monkey. So these are the animals that which live in the jungles. They are called as wild animals. Examples: lion, elephant, deer. So these are animals which live in jungles and in the zoo. They are called as wild animals. Next we are going to see domestic animals. The animals which we tame them. They are called as farm animals. We will tame them and we will take care of them. So these animals are useful for us also. So they are called as domestic animals. Animals like cow, sheep, horse and hen are here by us in the farms. These are called domestic or farm animals. These are very useful for us also. We are using them. So these animals are called as domestic animals or farm animals. So first we saw wild animals. Next we saw domestic animals. Now we are going to see pets. Pets means what? That animals we will keep them in our home. Like cat, dog, these are all our pet animals. So animals that we keep in our homes are called pets. Cats, dogs. So these are all the common pet animals we will keep in our home. Next, birds. Birds are the animals. Birds is the only animals which have wings and feather. These birds only will have feathers and wings. With the help of wings and feathers only, they can able to fly. So birds are animals with wings and feathers. The wings of the bird and their light body. The body will be very lightweight. With the help of that light body weight, they can easily fly from one place to another place. See how they were flying. With the help of their wings and feathers, they were able to fly. Birds only have beaks and crawls. Only the birds have beaks. Other than animals, they don't have beaks. Next, we are going to see insects. Insects are very tiny animals. Whether you all have seen in your house, cockroach, insects like ant, mosquitoes, butterflies, all these are very small, tiny animals. So, small insects. All the insects cannot fly. If you take ant, ant cannot fly. It will move slowly from one place to another. If you see butterfly, it will fly. So, insects cannot, some insects can fly, some insects cannot fly. Butterfly, mosquitoes, these can fly. But ant, it cannot fly. Next, now we are going to see foots of animals. We all need foots to live. Like that, animals also need foots to live. So, what are the foods the animals are eating? We are going to see. Now, different animals eat different types of food. Different animals. Cow will eat some food, dog will eat, so crow will eat some other food. So, like that, different animals will eat different kinds of foods. Now we are going to see what are the animals are eating, what type of food. Some animals eat only plants. Some animals will eat only plants. They are called as plant eaters. These animals are called as plant eaters. Example, elephant, cow, deer. So these animals, rabbit. So these animals will eat only the plants. Those animals will eat only plants. So they are called as plant eaters. What are the animals? I'm giving the examples like elephant, cow, deer, rabbit. These are the examples. These animals will eat plants. So they are called as plant eaters. Next, some animals will eat flesh of other animals. They will eat the flesh of other animals, the dead animals from that animals. They will eat the flesh of these animals. They are called as flesh eaters. These animals are called as flesh eaters. Example, wolf, tiger, and lion. These animals will eat the flesh of other animals. So they will eat the flesh of other animals. These are called as flesh eaters. Next, some animals, they will eat both plants and the animals. They will eat plants also and they will eat animals also. Example, bear. See this bear eating fish. So, it is a other animal only, flesh of other animal. See, crow, it will eat plants, everything. So, these are called as, these animals will eat both plants and the animals. Next, some animals eat insects. These animals, some animals, they will eat only small insects. Example, frog. If you see frog, see how is frog is eating the insects. So, it will eat small insects. Bat, it also will eat only the small insects. These frog and bat and all will eat the small insects. Next, so animals are also useful to us. From animals only we are getting so many food items. Milk, egg, chicken and all you are getting from the animals only. So, now we are going to see what are the things we are getting from animals. So, cow is also useful to us. Dog, it will safeguard from you. From the then, food giving animals. So, what are the animals giving food for us? Animals like cow, buffalo and goat gives us milk. So, cow, it gives us milk. Buffalo, they all these animals gives us milk. You all will drink milk, no? That milk is coming from the animal cow. Then from hen and duck we are getting eggs. So hen lays eggs and ducks also lays eggs. That egg only we are having as a food. Then some peoples, what they will do, they will eat the flesh of animals itself, like goat, hen, fish. So some peoples, they will eat the flesh of animals itself. We get honey from honeybee. So from honeybee we are getting honey. See how honeybee is sucking the flower. From that only we are getting honey. Fiber giving animals. From some animals they are giving fiber also. Fiber means what? We are all wearing the dresses, no? Your mother will be wearing silk saree. The thread, the silk thread like that. Then we are using bag, shoes. These are all the fiber giving. So some animals they are giving fibers also. We will see. We get silk fiber from silkworm. From silkworm we are getting silk. So like the from the silkworm they are making like this shell. From this they are making like a thread. From this thread only they are preparing like a saree. At last from silkworm only these process are happening. Then at last you are getting like this a saree, silk saree. Hair growing on the sheep, on the top of the sheep, like a hair, it will be soft, hair will be there. With that help of that hair only, they are making that you will be in the winter season, you will be wearing sweater, scarf, all those things are they are preparing. See, the sheep, from this sheep hair, it will be like this, it will be very soft. From this, they are preparing a woolen thread like this. From this, they are preparing like this, woolen thread. From this woolen thread, they are making a sweaters like this. Skin of the buffalo. You all have seen buffalo? Yeah, that skin and crocodile skin. From that skin, they are preparing the leather. So from that skin, they are making like this leather. From this leather, we are getting like this bag, purse, belt, jerkin, like this they are preparing. So some animals like donkey, see how donkey is carrying the loads. So these animals, donkey, horse, camels, these are all the animals help us to carry loads. From one place to another, like this they will carry their loads. It will carry loads from one place to another. These animals are called as beasts of burden. This animals called as beasts of burden. They will carry loads from one place to another. So to receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you, children.